In the last video, we ended with a plan about how we wanted to start getting ourselves familiar with the night sky. And we discussed that going via the Big Dipper and the North Star are probably a good way to start because they're sort of linked to each other in the sky. For instance, if you were able to find the Big Dipper, which is a very common pattern of this bowl here, then the two edge stars are called pointer stars, and they will point up to the North Star. And the pointing isn't in any arbitrary direction. It's always from sort of the bottom of the bowl here to the top, always on this edge here. So the top edge and the bottom edge are the two pointer stars, and you point up out away from the bowl, and this will be the North Star up here. So there's sort of a nice pair of patterns to get familiar with here. And of course, if you just sort of draw imaginary lines over these stars here, you can sort of see what the bowl looks like, something like that, okay? So here's sort of a more exact rendition of this here. It's an actual photograph of the sky with some lines drawn to illustrate what everything would look like then. So as you can see, as promised here, here are the stars that make up the handle of the Big Dipper, sort of four of them there. Then they go in and make the bowl like this here. And you can see that there's the two pointer stars right here. And the names of the stars are sort of, you know, maybe interesting to know, and maybe your first thing you can start to tell people, Dubie and Merak, are the two pointer stars. And as you can see then, like as promised here, as you take the pointer stars up and away from the bowl, up, until you finally hit a star, it's Polaris. And as I also mentioned in the last video, in this sort of this region here leading up to the North Star here, you might say, well, maybe I'll get stuck at some other star. It's curiously sort of void of stars. Like, it's really, really hard to get this wrong, because as you start to travel from the pointer stars up through this region here, there just aren't any stars that are going to confuse you. And when you hit Polaris right here, it's sort of the first star that you encounter that's an actual, clear, unambiguous star, and that'll usually be the North Star. So you can sort of get it that way. And the other thing is, we might just go ahead and answer question number 15 right now, is that as you do this sort of thing, the answer to 15 is just no. The North Star is not very bright at all. In fact, in a very thick star field, if you get some very dark night, is actually kind of hard to find a North Star without this guide of the Big Dipper nearby. So the North Star is not found because of its brightness at all. It's best found by being guided by the Big Dipper. Or if you think you found the North Star by itself, make sure you verify that. Come on down from the North Star and make sure you can see the pointer stars and the Big Dipper in some proper orientation like that. Just a couple things about the North Star now, is it turns out that the reason it is the North Star, I'll let you watch this video here a little bit, it'll repeat itself, is that as the Earth rotates, right above the North Pole, so there's the North Pole right there, and so right above this North Pole here, there's a star. So the images sort of go in and out, but I'll sort of maybe complete this arrow as I can here, right above the North Pole. There's a star there. North Pole is right there. It's a sheer cosmic coincidence. It has nothing to do with the formation of the Earth, or the star didn't come from the Earth, or the Earth didn't come from the star, anything like that. It just so happens that as the Earth spins right above the North Pole, there's a star there. So in other words, if you were a little person that was actually standing here on the North Pole and you look straight up like that, the North Star would be right above your head. It's just the way it works. Just something we're endowed with here living on Earth. This is the North Star or Polaris. Just the way it works. There's a star right above the North Pole. So in drawing anyway, just to wrap this up here, if you have the Earth like this, and there's the equator, which we're used to at 0 degrees and stuff, and there's the North Pole, and there's the South Pole right here, so this will be the North Pole, and that will be the South Pole right there. If you just sort of travel up, there's a star right above it here, which is Polaris or the North Star. Either way you want to think about it, there just happens to be a star right above the North Pole. Now, to be very exact about these things, it's not exactly above the North Pole. And so that is definitely true. It's not exactly above the North Pole. But for the reasons of this class and for any consequences of you being a better camper and doing things, just don't worry about that. As far as you know, the Polaris is directly above the North Pole, and that's good enough for us. Okay, so in the next video, I'm going to show you some evidence of this.